Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Today we'll discuss chronic liver disease and fasting in Ramadan, and we'll answer the questions, important questions, patient fasting or not fasting. At first, as regards chronic liver disease, can be defined as degeneration, fibrosis, and regeneration in the liver tissue. As regards the causes of chronic liver disease, in Egypt there are many important causes for chronic liver disease. At first, bilharzia diseases, endemic in Egypt in certain area. Also, post-hepatic cirrhosis, and this is now considered as the famous cause of chronic liver disease in Egypt, especially virus C. There is another causes, not important as before, like as metabolic cirrhosis, Wilson disease, hemochromatosis, cardiac cirrhosis. All these can be considered as the causes of chronic liver disease, also cryptogenic or idiopathic cirrhosis. As regards the clinical presentation of the chronic liver disease can be presented by many presentations. At first, weakness, easy fatigue, loss of weight, mild fever, gastrointestinal trouble such as dyspepsia, anorexia, vomiting. Also, patient can be suffer from bad odor of the mouth, foetal hepatics. Also, patient can be suffer from enlargement of the abdomen, ascites, and also edema of the lower limb. Also, patient may be suffer from pallor and manifestation of hyperdynamic circulation. All these presentation can be considered in the manifestation of chronic liver disease. Also, as regard the examination of the patients, there are many physical signs important in chronic liver disease, such as liver enlargement, splenomegaly, or presence of ascites. All these manifestation is also important, like pulmonary edema. This is considered one of manifestation of chronic liver disease with a spider nearby, spooning, sometimes clubbing, as in biliary cirrhosis. All these can be considered as a manifestation of chronic liver disease. To investigate this condition, usually we use a simple investigation like laboratory investigation, such as liver enzyme, SOGOT, SGEP, serum albumin, serum bilirubin, prothrombin time. Also, the blood picture is important in chronic liver disease as regard the platelet count, thrombocytopenia, or even anemia. Also, you use ultrasound, and this is very important today, and it is widespread and famous technology in Egypt to diagnose chronic liver disease, to see the cirrhotic liver and manifestation of cirrhosis, coarse liver, splenomegaly, ascites. And one of the important investigation of chronic liver disease is endoscopy to evaluate the presence of esophageal varices. Sometimes the patient may be presented for the first time by hematemesis, and sometimes the patient may be presented by hepatic coma, and can be considered this is the two famous complication of chronic liver disease is the hematemesis or chronic as a chronic liver disease or hepatic coma. This as regards the investigation, there are investigation towards the cause of chronic liver disease, such as to detect the viral marker, to detect bilharzia diseases, sigmoidoscopy, and rectal SNP, to detect the cause of cirrhosis or cause of chronic liver disease. As regards the management and as regards the important question today is the patient fasting or not fasting. At first, not all patients of chronic liver disease usually not fasting. No, patient with chronic liver disease can be fasting. But this is need to be evaluated by the doctor to evaluate the condition, the clinical condition, and the laboratory data of the patient. If the patient is considered as compensated chronic liver disease, yani no presence of ascites, no presence of edema, no presence of hematemesis, no presence of history of hepatic coma, and also the laboratory function proves this, like serum bilirubin normal, serum albumin more than 3. These patients considered as compensated chronic liver disease, and this patient can start to starvation with some advice to him, usually at the end of starvation, to take more carbohydrate to support the glycogen pattern of the chronic liver disease, of the liver state. As regards the other group of patients with decompensated liver, a patient presented with ascites, presented with edema, had a history of hepatic coma, history of hematemesis. Also, the investigation proved this condition of decompensation, like serum albumin is below 3 gram, or serum bilirubin rise more than 1 milligram percent, or liver enzymes is elevated. All these condition proves that patient is decompensated chronic liver disease, and the patient with chronic decompensated liver disease cannot be starvated. And this patient cannot stand starvation, and they can be easily developed hypoglycemia, can be entered to a hepatic coma, and advise this patient not to starve and not to take starvation as an important point in his life. Only the patient with compensated liver disease can start starvation and can dealing with the starvation with the good support of carbohydrate at the end of the day, but patient with chronic liver disease and the decompensated condition cannot be starved. As regards the complication of the chronic liver disease, patient presented with hematemesis, patient presented with hepatic coma, this patient no starvation at all, and patient should be admitted to hospital to be controlled, because this condition is an emergent condition and need important medical care. As regards hematemesis, patient need to take blood transfusion, liver support, intravenous fluid, and do endoscopy to be controlled the esophageal varices by injecting it with sclerosing material like scopolamine. Also, as regards hepatic coma, patient should be admitted to hospital, and this is the emergent condition. Patient cannot starvated, and patient should be put in medical care, emergency medical care, to control the condition, stop protein diet, take intravenous fluid, do rectal enema to support the condition of the liver, and also can control the condition of precipitating factor like hematemesis, like electrolyte disturbance, to avoid the progression of the hepatic coma, and can stop these cycles of hepatic coma, and the condition may be improved on this line of management. All these two complications cannot be starvated at all. Thank you, and good luck.